Third important factor in sheet metal cutting operations is cutting forces that are required to perform a cutting operation. This is important because we have to determine the press size or the tonnage of the press that will be used to perform that operation. So the force required to perform a cutting operation is the product of three factors. So here S subscript S is the shear strength of the metal being cut, T is the stock thickness or the thickness of the sheet, and L is the length of cut edge, or that is basically the length of the boundary or the perimeter of the part that we are cutting. So in blanking and punching, L is the perimeter length of the blank or hole being cut. So for circular or round holes or blanks, the formula turns out to be shear strength into thickness into pi d. So pi d is the circumference or the length of the boundary of the circular hole or blank. Now, if shear strength is unknown, an alternative way of estimating the cutting force is to use the tensile strength, and formula turns out to be 0.7 into tensile strength into thickness into length of cut edge. So if shear strength is not known, but tensile strength is known, then we can use this formula, and this will give approximately the same result as this original formula. So let's find the cutting force required for the blank that we have been discussing already. We discussed the same blank for scrap strip layout and for determining the size of punch and die. So we have to calculate the tonnage required to cut the blank shown if the material is SAE1010, that is mild steel with a shearing strength of 40,000 psi. So this is the formula. So we know two factors, that is the thickness as well as shear strength. So only thing we have to calculate is L, that is the perimeter of the blank. So that will be equal to the sum of the different values that are defining the boundary of this blank. So that will be equal to 4 plus this 0.875 plus this is equal to 1.125 plus this 1.25 plus again this is 1.125 plus this is 0.875 plus this 4 plus this will be equal to pi d over 2. So that will be equal to 1.5707, and again this length is 1.25, again a semicircle, so that will be pi d over 2, so that is 1.5707, again this length is 1.25, and again finally the semicircle, pi d over 2, that is 1.5707. So we started with this 4 and then 0.875, 1.125, and so on. So that turns out to be 20.46 inches. So multiplying these three factors, 40,000 into 0.02 into 20.46, turns out to be 16,368 pounds. That divided by 2,000 turns out to be 8.2 tons. So we may need a press of say 10 ton or greater capacity to perform this operation. Now, how we can reduce these cutting forces? There are two ways. The first is to apply shear to punch and die. That is something we have already discussed. Grind the face of the punch or die at small shear angle with horizontal. Shear also reduces the shock to the press and smoothes out the cutting operation. So we could have a single angle shear or we could have double angle shear. Double angle shear is preferred over single angle shear because it does not set up lateral forces. The second option is to step punch length. So this is practically an important consideration in the case of progressive dies. So one of the options is to apply shear to the punch or die. So here we have applied shear some angle to the punch. So this is the shear that we have applied. In this case, we have applied shear to the die. And in both cases, this is a single angle shear. It could be a double shear, something like this. So here we have applied double shear. So on both sides, we have applied a shear in different ways to the punch in this case. And as you might have noticed in one of the figures in the previous segments, where we calculated the sizes of punch and die, we had applied convex shear in that case. So this is one of the possibilities to reduce the cutting forces, to apply shear, either single shear or double shear, to the punch and die. The second application is in the case of progressive dies. So for example, here we are having two punches, the piercing punch and the blanking punch. So you could notice that the length of the piercing punch is smaller as compared to the blanking punch. So once the blanking punch, the second punch, will pass through the sheet, then the second punch, actually in this case the first punch, that is the piercing punch, will come in contact with the sheet. So the difference in length is slightly greater than the thickness of the sheet. So once this punch two will have passed through the sheet, then the second, then in this case actually this punch one, will come in contact with the sheet. So at one time, one of these punches will be in contact with the sheet. So the force required actually will be equal to greater of these two forces because of forces developed by each of these punches. So I repeat that first this punch two will cut the sheet, that is the blanking operation, then punch one will actually perform the punching operation or the piercing operation. So at one time, only one of these punches will be in contact with the sheet. So the force will reduce, but this point is applicable for progressive dies. But for single station dies, this option of applying shear, either single or double, to the punch or die is a practical solution. So if you are not applying shear to the punch, something like this, you could see the maximum force required is quite high, but once we have applied shear to the punch, the maximum force required reduces dramatically. So that is the big benefit of applying shear to the punch. So blanking with square faced punch left and one containing angular shear right, note the difference in maximum force and contact stroke. The total work, the area under the curve, is the same for both processes. So that will be the same in both cases. Now, if shear is applied to the punch, the force necessary to cut through the material is reduced, equal to a factor K, and that K is equal to TP over S. T is again the thickness of the sheet, P is the percent penetration, and S is the shear. So S should always be greater than TP. So this should be kept in mind, that this ratio K should be less than 1. And that will be less than 1 if S is greater than the product of T into P. So S should be always greater than T into P, otherwise the force after applying shear will be greater than F, that is force without shear, and there will be no purpose in applying shear to the punch or die. So, and that should be kept in mind. So applying shear to the punch significantly reduces the cutting forces. Thank you very much.